Yeshiva World.
This share today was going to be about Megillah, but it's really going to be about Shavuos, because Megillah and Shavuos are effectively the same thing, apart from the fact that they have nothing to do with each other. There's a Megillah that we read on Shavuos called Rus, the Sfas Emes discusses the concept that's mentioned in the Gemara in Shabbos. The Gemara in Shabbos says something that you've probably heard before, you may not have heard it. It says that Hashem kafa alehem harakigigis, Hashem put the mountain over the people, like a kind of a large barrel, and said to them, if you accept the Torah, fantastic, and if not, well, you can be buried under this mountain. So the people gave it a long, considered thought and said, we'll be buried we'll accept the Torah. And they accepted the Torah. The Gemara then says, but that's not fair then. They were kind of forced into it. They were roped into accepting the Torah. And it says, yeah, but they went back. They went back in the times of Achashverosh in the Megillah to accept the Torah again properly. The question is this: why did Hashem hold the mountain over them? Or what is that image supposed to tell us? Why the force? Why are we supposed to understand the force into it? The Sfas Emes is a beautiful, beautiful idea, which is based on a Medrash. The Medrash says that at the time of the Aseret HaDibros, when Hashem gave the Ten Commandments, so Parcha Nishmasam, their neshamas all left them. Everyone died completely. And then they were brought back to life again. And they died again, and they were brought back to life again. Well, why did everyone have to die? What's the big deal? The normal understanding is that they were exposed to Hashem, and you can't be exposed to Hashem in an unadulterated sense without losing your life and forfeiting it. Forfeiting your life. So what's the big deal about Shavuos? What happened then? So Sfas Emes has a very beautiful idea. That every single thing in life, everything, has a certain spark inside it, has a certain moment of Kedusha, has a certain aspect of holiness about it. That however good, bad, or ugly that thing seems in creation, then it has an ultimate purpose. At the time of Har Sinai, when they had this experience at Mount Sinai, as we know it says in Dayenu, if Hashem would have done this, and wouldn't have done that, it would have been enough. When it comes to going to Har Sinai, it says, Ilu kervanu lefnei Har Sinai, velo nasananas haTorah, Dayenu. Hashem would have taken us to Har Sinai, and not given us the Torah, so it would have been enough. Why would it have been enough? It's a complete detour for no reason. The answer seems to be that there were two things that happened on Har Sinai. One was that we received the Torah, and the one was before that, Ma'amad Har Sinai. There was a certain event that happened at Har Sinai that changed our lives forever. What changed is that we all had a perspective on reality, that we saw that individual point of creation that every single thing connects together. When that happened, everyone saw the real thing. So everyone realized, that's it, we understand the whole purpose of life. There is no concept of negativity, there's no concept of wrath, there's no external shell for anything. Everything's just integrally true, and therefore everyone effectively died because all living ceased to exist. What happened after Matan Torah, what happened after Har Sinai, is that everything went back to how it was before. And our challenge every year on Shavuos and beyond is to always try to locate that inner point inside everything, to understand that although really that's the ultimate truth, and we say Einod Milvado, there's nothing other than Hashem, we have to get used to living in a world where it looks like Einod Milvado. If I could say one more idea about that, there's a concept of the bracha of Hamotzi Lechem Min Ha'aretz. We say, Baruch Atah Hashem Elokeinu Melech Ha'olam, Hamotzi Lechem Min Ha'aretz. We bless Hashem and say that you take bread out of the ground. It's not true. It's a lie. He doesn't take bread out of the ground. I don't know if you know anything about agriculture, but you don't go down to the farm in England and say, oh, I make bread up in the ground. It doesn't work like that. First of all, because you'd have a very strange life if you spoke like that all the time. But also because that's not how it works. We take grain out of the ground. We take wheat out of the ground more precisely. We grind it up, make it into flour, and everything make bread. So the real explanation of it normally is Hamotzi Lechem Ha'aretz, Hashem helps us with all the processes that bring bread out of the ground. He doesn't do the bread bit, we do the bread bit, but we couldn't have done that without him. That sounds very nice, except for one problem. When Adam HaRishon was in Gan Eden, and him and Chava sinned, and the Nachash was involved, then Hashem gave them punishment, and the punishment of Adam was Bezeh HaSapech HaTeuch HaLachem, by the sweat of your brow you'll eat bread. And that's the punishment. If you understand it simply stated, it means up until now you had bread, and it was all there on a plate for you. From now on, you're going to have to sweat. You're going to have to make it yourself. But if the bracha Hamotzi Lechem Min Ha'aretz really means you don't really do any of the processes, Hashem gives you the strength to do everything, what's the punishment? Before Hashem gave you everything on a plate, and now He gives you everything on a plate. What's the big punishment? Everything's done by Hashem anyway, even the processes that make bread. So the answer seems to be given. Rav Dessler, I think, says this very beautifully, that Adam Rishon lived in a world of complete clarity, like we had on Har Sinai. He knew how everything worked, everything fit together beautifully. The punishment for Adam Rishon wasn't that he was going to live in a world where he really had to sweat to make bread, because Hashem does all the processes and helps us through all of them. The difference was he had to live in a world where it looked like You had to move in a world where it looked like it. When I sweat, things happen. And that's a very dangerous world to live in, because sometimes you can really believe that your own actions actually change the whole world on your own without any involvement of Hashem. That's the challenge maybe of all of our lives, particularly in Shavuos, to remember that everything stems from a singular point, that the Torah is the basis of all the spiritual points that lie within all of us in the whole world. It's a fantastic Shavuos, please go to.